now, cause I'm on fire. I can't give a about what they say. They've been searching for that thing to get them higher. You can't catch my drift, can't catch my wave.
Damn, Kane, you done kill Abel. Unbalanced land, trying to keep the people stable. The way I feel, I might it all up. The way you feel, you might do it for the buck. All black, born to be a rebel. After this, I might go in water down the devil. Listen to everything around me, I can't see. Picked a dozen roses and left them.
The NFL on EA Sports brings us to the banks of the Ohio River and Paul Brown Stadium in Cincinnati. The enthusiasm of this Cincinnati crowd in full effect a moment ago as their Bengals took the field, to the delight of this sold-out crowd. And they're all set as they'll match up with the Seattle Seahawks. Now it's Wilson. And able to take it past the 25 and up to the 28-yard line.
The Bengals take over first and 10 at their own 28-yard line.
On the ground, this is Joe Mixon. He'll wind up getting a yard on the game's first play at second down.
Yeah, things were pretty stacked up there in the middle of the line. A lot of bodies, not much space. I think ultimately he was fortunate to get anything out of that run.
Here's second and 9, just a yard on that last run. Burrow going to give this to Mixon. And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. A gain of 13, it's a first down. Well, one unit I know you want to watch is that offensive line. If they keep clearing holes like that, it could be a long night defensively.
No doubt about it, because when they are in sync, as we're seeing so far, when that continuity is there and you can see that they're playing off of each other while controlling the defensive front linebackers, you're exactly right. It could be a very long night for the defense because someone's going to run for some big yardage.
Mixon with a first down carry. And very little daylight there. He'll get a couple up to the 44.
Well, any lane that might have been open there was closed pretty quickly, and that was because the defensive front, they won that battle at the point of attack at the line of scrimmage. They used great leverage, held their spot, and stacked him up.
The last run got a couple. Here's second and 8. Now Joe Mixon. And he's up across midfield and down into Seattle territory. Good work to pick up 7 yards there. That gets him into a 3rd-and-1 situation.
7 brings up 3rd-and-1.
Here's Burrow. And he's going to be stopped up right at the line of scrimmage. So no sack. He gets back to the line of scrimmage, but it'll still bring up a 4th down.
Well, the defensive guys won't be real happy because there won't be a sack on this play because he did get back to the line of scrimmage. But what a job they did overall. Hemmed him in and gave him nowhere to go with the football.
And now the Seahawks are going to take a timeout here on defense. They'll have 2 remaining as we step aside here in this first quarter. And on their first drive, the offense staying out there. They're going to go for it on 4th. They'll run with Mixon, and he's not going to get there. Might have even lost a yard. Denied on 4th down is Joe Mixon. And this defense holds on the night's opening drive. Wilson and the Seahawks take over now, 1st and 10, right at the 50-yard line. Flush to his right. That's complete to DK Metcalf. And he goes down, but not before getting this inside the 25. A good pickup there, 26 yards. Now it's Wilson. Being chased out left. And he can't find a receiver, and he's brought down. Carl Lawson with a little how do you do as he gets in there for the sack. Work to be done here on 2nd and 16 after the sack. eluding the pressure right. Got a man, and he hits him in stride. And he takes it down to the 10-yard line. 19 yards to pick up there. Move the chains. On first and 10, it's Wilson. Flight, and he can't get rid of it. He's taken down. There's Sam Hubbard that time in there to bring him to the ground. And they need to work to at least get some of this yardage back after the sack. Second and 19. This throw complete. Wilson finding Lockett. Only 3 yards on the catch. It's third down.
A three-yard pickup. And it's third down.
Third and long. It's Wilson. Dancing to his left. Trying to fit it into Moore, but it's intercepted. Hooked up by Jesse Bates. Oh, no doubt, a very disappointing end to what was a pretty strong opening drive.
They had 3 points in their back pocket. It was there for them. If you don't like what you see, just throw it away. Make sure you get those points on the board. Don't get too greedy. He forced it there. You saw the end result.
And able to get it across the 10 to the 15. They were looking for a little spark and some breathing room. They got it right there, a gain of 14 and a first down.
At the 15-yard line.
Line of scrimmage, the 15. It's first and 10. They'll run with Mixon. They get him to the ground right on the cusp of the red zone after a pickup of 5 or 6.
On the tackle.
After the pickup of 5, here's 2nd and 5.
Second and 5 at the 20-yard line.
Now they run with Mixon, and he'll be taken down here at about the 23-yard line.
Mixon, the ball carrier. He was taken down by Bobby Wagner. A gain of 2 brings up 3rd and 2.
No score after 1 on EA Sports.
No score.
So 3rd and 2, and I count 6 defensive backs out there. They give to Mixon to try to pick it up. And boy, he is very close to a first down, but from where they're spotting that football, he's going to be a foot or so short. 2 yards on the pick up there, it's 4th down. So in their own territory, but they only need a few inches, so they're going to opt to go for this thing. We'll see, maybe a surprise pass or run. What will they do? We're about to find out. 4th down. They run for it with Mixon, and he picks up the first before he's taken down at the 29. They only needed a few inches, but still some anxious moments there, but they do convert on 4th. The 4th down run successful. Now they look to pay it off on 1st down. They'll run here with Mixon. He'll have a 1st down past the 40 as he'll get this one up to the 44-yard line. That one good for 15, and the Bengals get a 1st down.
Partner, in our years together, we've never really run into a player that's admitted a doubt or a lack of confidence, right? But right now, I'm just wondering about that interior line because on defense, they're starting to get manhandled at the point of attack. Do they have it in them to figure a way to reverse the tide? Because right now, they're running the ball at will.
He was looking for his favorite target, A.J. Green, that time. And that'll bring up 2nd down. An incomplete pass on 1st down. That leads to a 2nd and 10. Mixon. And a minimal gain here as he's up to about the 47-yard line. He'll get only 3 there, so it leaves him with a 3rd and 7 ahead. Pretty good little two-play sequence there. You force the incompletion, then a very short pickup.
Yeah, now maybe you bring in an extra defensive back or 2 because you want to try and defend on 3rd down. They like to play those nickel or sub packages, don't they?
He's going to air it out deep for Green. Now a clash of bodies here, and it's intercepted. Shaquille Griffin with a pick. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back.
First and 10.
Defensively that time, they were in zone coverage. As a rookie QB, what lesson can you learn there?
Well, understand this. You saw zone in college, and the defensive backs reacted, but they don't react like they do on this level. So when they're in zone and they see the ball coming to them, they'll react at least a half a second faster. You've got to know where you want to go with the ball and be decisive with it. Otherwise, the end result can be something you don't like.
And he is out of bounds, able to get it across the 20-yard line. Good coverage downfield led to him taking off, picking up the first down on a 13-yard run. Well, throw on first down with Wilson. Escaping the pressure right. Out to the right, he gets it to Lockett. And they'll get it all the way up about 5 yards shy of midfield. Good work after the catch. Going to net him 23 and a first. Now Wilson. Buying time to his left. A 50-50 ball here, and it's intercepted. William Jackson with a pick. And they will set up shop at their own 41-yard line. Second straight drive now here, Charles, that have ended with an interception.
And I just wonder, because I don't think it's going to rattle him necessarily, but I also wonder if it's going to unnerve him a little bit. Does it lead to another one, or does he find a way to pull it together and become sharp again?
Here's Joe Mixon as they start on the ground. And they're well past midfield, just a yard or two shy of the 40. This drive starting off on the right foot, 18 yards.
That was good, tough running right up the middle. And if the defense can't penetrate and make him slow his pace or change direction, that's often the end result.
First and 10, and they've got three tight ends out there. A jumbo package look. Now it's Burrow. Oh, a ball batted in the air, and now it's intercepted. Picked off by Jamal Adams. And he's free going down the left side. It's a foot race. And he's going to score. It's a Seahawk touchdown. Ah, yes, the old tip drill works to perfection there.
Ah, you're bringing back great memories. Used to love that drill. And a lot of times in practice, you work on it, not just one tip, but multiple tips, just in case the ball stays in the air for a while, to have an awareness and the ability to go up and grab it, and then you want to get some blocking support and end up in the opposite end zone.
In that tip drill, what do you yell?
For us, it was Oski. Okay, Oski was an interception.
For different teams.
Different teams have different ways of doing it. I've heard bingo, jackpot. The worst I ever heard, though, was Frankenstein. You don't want it to be a
two-syllable word. Yeah.
You want to get it right down and go. Oski is really the preferred word.
Oski. The Bengals drive about to get going. It hasn't gone particularly well for them. That's obvious. In these conditions, no points so far. They've got to get that offense on track. The question, how do they do it?
It is the age-old question, isn't it? And to me, finding a way to make sure your playmakers touch the ball without it being too exotic, meaning you don't have to go deep down the field. Maybe you hit them on those short passes on the perimeter. Make sure you just turn around and hand it to your best runner and get out of the way. Don't cause any extra stress on your offense.
On second down, here's Mixon. And he'll be brought down shy of the 40 at the 38-yard line. 4 yards the pickup, first down.
And that last carry puts him right at 100 yards for the game. So how has he done it? Because he's been patient, followed his blocks, let everything develop, and then burst through for big gains.
They show run with three tight ends here on first down. On the run, it's Mixon. And a good swarm to the football defensively as they get him down at about the 40. Making the stop that time, Bobby Wagner.
That was a pretty good job defensively to hold him to a 2-yard run. But I've got to think this offensive line, they're asking their quarterback for a different type of a run. One that they rely on, one they have confidence in, one they feel like they can block.
The last run good for two. Here's second and 8. Mixon. Oh, he's got a little daylight. And he'll be taken down, but not before he gets into enemy territory. A gain of 13. It's a first down. Three tight ends in the ball game here on first and 10. And he He's corralled, but not before getting it inside the 35. They'll get 13 yards for the second play in a row. All right, I got to ask you, with these RPOs, essentially the quarterback has three options, right? So what's different from that versus the triple option that we see the service academies run at the college level?
As a general rule, the triple option at the college level, most things are called outside of the quarterback faking it to the runner and then keeping it himself and maybe having a trail back. What I mean is, in the NFL, that option to throw the football all comes about organically. It's a natural deal based on reads. In college, if you're going to throw the football off a triple option, you've actually called that play.
So that flag will cost him 15.
And it doesn't matter anymore how you get the face mask. Any part of it, that's going to be 15 yards.
So the face mask, quite a blessing there as they'll start out of harm's way with a first and 10. And this will leave them a yard short. Nice pickup of 9 yards on first down.
At the 2-yard line, a gain of 9 brings up second and 1.
That's it for the first half. Two more quarters to go. We'll have plenty more to see after the break. And we welcome you back now. Alongside Charles Davis, I'm Brandon Gordon, getting set for quarter number 3 here.
Randy Mullen to kick off for Cincinnati.
Forecast calling for more of the same. The rain set to continue as we are underway in the second half. And able to get this out to the 25.
Take over first and 10 at their own 25-yard line.
Coming to the line here to begin their next drive, the Seahawks offense. They have the lead. Now they'll be looking to extend that lead.
And this is where I enjoy talking about one of my favorite subjects, tendency breakers, or counters, as I also like to call them. You've done things in a certain way in the first half, and they've had ability to see what you've done. They're going to make their adjustments. So guess what? You adjust yourself and try and stay ahead of the pace because you are looking for some separation in this ballgame.
The adjustment to the adjustment.
Without a doubt. Show them one thing, hit them with something else.
Now looks for Lockett once more. This time he's got him. It's a first down, his fourth catch of the game after having 3 in the first half.
First down.
Here's Wilson.
But one of the ways the quarterbacks keep all the receivers alive in a play, never lock in on any one guy. Make sure you keep your eyes moving, scan the field. And here he finds the open guy for a nice pickup.
And 3 at the 50-yard line.
Forced out to his left. He'll run it. And he's got this down a yard or two shy of the 40 before he's out of bounds. The rushing numbers for Wilson, maybe down from earlier in his career, but he's still a threat to go, showing it there, picking up the first down. Now Wilson on first down. Flush to his right. They'll find Metcalf. And they'll wind up getting this one all the way down inside the 20. 23 yards on the play. Wilson steps away to his left. And Wilson's going to be intercepted a third time. William Jackson with a pick. And he brings it back to right around the 26-yard line. It was a drive that had real promise here to begin the third quarter, but ultimately derailed by the INT.
And that was the position you wanted to be in, coming out to start this third quarter, get a nice drive going, looking for the end zone. Possibly got a little bit too greedy right there.
And he ran right through one tackle as he fights forward for a gain of 7.
Down at the 33-yard line.
3 yards to go on second down, and they've got 3 tight ends out there. Jumbo set. 54 is Mike. Check, check. Watch 54. Again, it's Mixon. And he'll be brought down right around the 37.
Oh, Mixon.
Not a whole lot there. The defense was ready, it looked, for that run-pass option.
You get the sense the next time he has that opportunity, he may keep it himself and get to the perimeter. Probably owes his back a little bit of an apology on that one, huh?
Line of scrimmage, the 37 on first and 10.
Right there. 54, right there, right there. 54, Mike.
On first down, Mixon. And getting this just shy of midfield, they'll spot it at the 49. 12 yards that time and a Cincinnati first down. Seemed like a couple sets of eyes were on the quarterback, so he decided, hey, I'm going to hand this off. Got a good gain out of it.
And you know you need good blocking up front in order to gain yardage, but every one of these RPOs, if you do it right and they look the same, whether it's handed off inside or the quarterback keeps it, that allows you to fool the defense so often. And in this case, fooled him with the inside run.
He's going to air it out deep for Green. And now Burrow going to be intercepted yet again. Shaquille Griffin with a pick. And he will bring this across midfield to the 49-yard line. Certainly not what he was hoping for, Charles. That's now three interceptions in this ballgame.
But there's a lot of knowledge to be gleaned every time you throw an interception if you do things the right way. And hasn't there been a pretty darn good quarterback along the way who threw a lot of interceptions early, learned from them, and became great later?
Who would that be?
That'd be one Peyton Manning.
Wilson hit. It's loose. It's out. Fumble. Able to fall on it, but look where they recovered it. That's a big loss.
A lot of bad news on that play for them, wasn't there? Lost the football, lost a lot of yardage, but I think the good news outweighs it. Able to retain possession. That was big for them.
So they keep the ball, but work to do on second and long. Now it's Wilson. And that'll be incomplete. Wilson took a pretty good shot as he tried to pull that one in. Couldn't hang on third down.
Well, as we get ready for third down, let's go back and recap here. The sack on the first play of this drive, that threw a wrench in what they were trying to accomplish because they were compelled to throw the ball on second down. A running play was not in the works. And that incompletion set up another passing down here on third and long.
An incomplete pass on that last play, and that means they'll need to come up with something here on third down. And that will be incomplete.
They certainly had good starting field position on that drive, but couldn't do anything with it after three plays. Have to admit that that's a disappointing end to excellent field position. When that drive started, they had 6 points that they were thinking about.
Wilson and the offense not coming off the field. They're going for it on fourth. Here we go on fourth with Wilson. Going for Metcalf on the deep ball. And this will be caught by Metcalf for a Seahawk touchdown.
14, DK Metcalf.
DK Metcalf. 59 yards. Here the Seahawks are able to stretch that lead out a bit further. So now a two-point conversion attempt coming for Wilson and the Seahawks. Again, Wilson eluding the pressure right. And they're going to get it. That one's caught. And now the lead moves to 16-0.
16. Bengals nothing. Jason Myers to kick off.
After the touchdown, here's Myers to boot it away. The return man, Wilson. And a decent return out to the 27-yard line.
The return. The Bengals take over first and 10 at their own 27-yard line.
The Cincy offense about ready to go here on their next drive. They're down a couple of scores, 16-0, as they start things out with a first and 10. Mixon gets the nod to start the drive, and he'll push his way forward to about the 32. 5 yards is the tally on first down. That brings up second and five.
Brings up second and five at the 32-yard line.
Once again, they run with Mixon. After a gain of five, they'll wind up being about a length of the football short here on third down. Pretty good job defensively. Thought he was going to get it, but they knew where that marker was, and they stopped him just short of it.
What it does is emphasize that strategic football and situational football is not just played on the offensive side, is it? Defense understanding, as you noted, where the first down marker was and making sure they didn't get there.
The safety, Jamal Adams, able to break that one up.
Sample incomplete. He was covered by Jamal Adams.
And in their own territory, needing only a few inches, they're going to line up to go for this thing on fourth down. And for the fourth time tonight, it's an interception. Picked off by Quandre Diggs. And his guys are going to take over at the 39-yard line.
First and 10 at the 39-yard line.
Trying to get one more in here before the quarter breaks. After the interception, here's Wilson. He lets this one fly toward the back of the end zone. And that one incomplete. They try to sneak in a deep ball with the clock running down. But to no avail as time will expire on this third quarter of play. So line of scrimmage, still the 39 on second and 10. To throw again, Wilson. And he comes back with one complete. And brought down, but not before they're inside the 25. 15 yards on the play, first down.
First down, Seattle.
Going right side here, and that's complete. And brought down, but not before they get it inside the 10 to the 7. Another first down as he went right back to the same well, this time for 17 yards. Two big plays in succession. Not sure this D knows what hit him, but now they got to get ready. It's first and goal. To throw again is Wilson. Flushed out right. And he's gonna score. It's a Seahawk touchdown.
Touchdown.
Taking it in from 7 yards away. And the Seahawks find a way to stretch their lead.
He didn't originally want to run, but he didn't see anything in the passing game, so he scrambled. And wouldn't you know it, he scores a touchdown anyway. It's awfully nice to have a quarterback who can make things happen with his legs.
The Seahawks offense staying put out on the field. They're going to go for two. Now Wilson escaping the pressure right. And this is going to be caught. So add two more to the lead as they continue to pour it on here in the fourth.
Bengals nothing. Jason Myers to kick off for Seattle.
And after the touchdown, here's Myers to boot it away. And this will make it into the end zone. And no chance to get away as they'll get him down at about the 17-yard line.
Bengals take over first and 10 at their own 17.
The Bengals drive about to get going. And let's face it, this drive is not going to have any bearing on this game, but it's kind of important for one reason, isn't it?
It certainly is. You got to get points. And okay, all right, I'm being facetious here. But you get points, you feel a little bit better about yourself as you move on to the next one.
7-yard pickup brings up second and 3.
They'll stay on the ground, mix it again. Call it a gain of 3, but not enough to move the sticks. It'll be third and about a foot or two.
Brings up third down.
Well, she gonna put it on me, that's a lot of it. For a cool sports season, drop the top. The offense on third down tonight, not good. 0 for 4 thus far. They're looking at third and a few inches. Now Mixon. And he won't be close to a first down as he runs into a wall right around the line of scrimmage. They call it no gain there, and it leads to a fourth down.
No gain on the play.
All right, they're going to try and keep hope alive here on fourth down. They're going for it. They'll try and run for it. And he picks up the first before he's taken down at the 29. But no reason not to try it there, and they do indeed convert on fourth. The fourth down run successful. Now they look to pay it off on first down. He'll have a first down past the 40, and he'll take it to the 43-yard line. That one good for 15, and the Bengals get a first down.
Nice game there, partner, but you and I both know that won't do anything for the final score. They're not going to win this one. Right now, they're playing for pride and fantasy points.
And just to erase that goose egg, nobody wants to be shut out. Just 2 minutes remaining here in the fourth quarter of what has been a one-sided affair. So the Bengals in possession of the football here as we get you reset. They've got a first and 10 as they search for a late score. Burrow with a throw caught by Green. So fresh out of the two-minute warning, and here's another timeout taken with 1:55 remaining. 3 yards the gain there, second down. That first down completion only netted him 3. Second and 7. Out of the gun, it's Burrow. And that is incomplete. A lot of force bearing down on him there. He could not hang on. It's third down. Well, it just seems like all game long there hasn't been a lot of sync quarterback to wide receiver on this side of the football.
They haven't been on the same page, quarterback and receivers. Heck, they haven't been on the same grease board when you draw plays up. They haven't been on the same surface tablet that you look at on the sidelines. Nothing's worked for them. They've got to find a way to start matching each other's movements.
Here's play number 7 on the drive. This is 3rd and 7. Boy, and now they can't even get a playoff. He didn't seem in a rush. I guess they just didn't know where the play clock was.
I think you're right about that because there was no hurried movements there, right? No up-tempo at all. Clock just ran out. I think he was as surprised as maybe his bench was.
He's going to let it fly. And that is caught one-handed. Oh, my. He pulled it in. A big third down play there for the Bengals. 42 yards. So the ball down to the 16 here for 1st and 10. This is Mixon. And he's brought down. Another nice gain. 16 yards there and a first down again. Two big plays in succession. Not sure this D knows what hit. And he takes it into the end zone. Touchdown, Bengals. Joe Mixon taking it in. And the Bengals are able to cut into this lead. So now the Bengals' offense will stay out there as they'll decide to go for 2. They'll try and run with Bernard. And he will get into the end zone to cut the lead a little bit further.
Score Seahawks 24, Bengals 8.
Now Bullock will send this one away after the touchdown. Taken from about the 12. And they'll get him down inside the 30 at the 27.
Over 1st and 10 at their own 27-yard line.
Coming to the line here to begin their next drive, the Seahawks offense. And a few kneel downs should just about do it. Now, defensively, they do have all 3 timeouts, but very little reason to use them at this point. Throwing right, and that's complete. And he'll be tackled right on the chalk of the 45. An excellent way to start the drive there, 18 yards.
Seahawks.
Going to throw right side here. Complete. Now the Seahawks call the 2nd of their 3 timeouts.
A gain of 11.
That'll leave them with just 1 remaining in this 4th quarter of play. Back-to-back good plays have them on the move on 1st down. Wilson wants to throw it. There goes a deep ball, end zone. And that is incomplete. So 17 seconds now on the clock here. The intended receiver was DK Metcalf. That'll bring up second down. And that's going to be incomplete. 12 seconds left.
Intended for Tyler Lockett. Incomplete. It's third down and 10 yards to go.
Now the Seahawks forced to use their third and final timeout. And as the two teams talk it over on their respective sidelines, we take a break. Now they face a third and 10 after back-to-back incompletions. Throwing again here, Wilson. Oh, he's going to let this go for the end zone. And this will be caught by Metcalf for a Seahawk touchdown. DK Metcalf, his second touchdown of the night. And the Seahawks add on to their lead.
Well, this is long since over, and some might see this as overkill, but remember, this is a team that puts on the hard hats, grabs the lunch pail, and tells everyone, we're going to give you a full 60 minutes. And that's exactly how they're playing this one out.
Oh, it's a fake. They'll try and throw for it. And that is incomplete. 7 seconds remaining.
I have to admit, I'm scratching my head a little bit here trying to make sense of what I just saw. Number one, huge lead. Just kick the extra point and be done with it. Number two, if you are going to go for two, just line up and go for it from the two-yard line. Why make it so difficult? That's a long way to go to try and pick up some points.
The Bengals take over first and 10 at their own 25-yard line.
The Cincy offense about ready to go here on their next drive. They've lost this one. Their offense has struggled. Do they try to put together something here at the end just to take into next week?
Yeah, sometimes teams want to do that. Coaches want to. I remember one time I was on a team and we were losing late in the game like this, and you knew it was lost. It was over, right? And a coach called a running play and pretty much said to everyone, I want to see something executed well before we get out of here. And that was the message to the team.
Just something to build on.
Just something to build on. Get it done. And maybe we can look at that and say, we'll get better as we go forward.
So that'll do it for my partner, Charles Davis, and the best darn crew in the industry. I'm Brandon Gaughton. This has been a presentation of the NFL on EA Sports. From Cincinnati, good night, everybody.
Chains, I get through the pain. Taste sweet on my face like it's lemonade.